Hello, in this video, we'll look at upload and download operations in ImageKit. Let's begin with the file upload operations. ImageKit allows you to set default upload parameters for your assets, which will help you standardize your asset uploads. These settings decide how your file will be renamed, how overwrites will happen, how tagging will be done by default. Now let's look at the various upload options in ImageKit. You can upload media assets directly from your device or upload from any existing file storage like Google Drive, Dropbox, etc. You can also directly add a file URL and upload it to the media library. If you are looking for stock photography in your media operations, you can use the Unsplash integration to search for the right asset within the media library, saving precious time and effort. In all the upload options, you can edit the default upload settings for each asset individually, or use the common setting to edit it for all the assets. You can upload folders containing multiple assets to the media library. Similar to individual asset uploads, you can change the setting of assets in the folder. The folder structure of the uploaded folder is always preserved, ensuring smooth media operations. Now let's look at the download options in ImageKit. You can download single or multiple assets as a zip file using the right-click menu or the global option. Use the Apply Transformations option to download resized versions of the assets in the zip and reduce your creative team's effort. You can access the download menu and download the assets when ready. The zip file will be available for 7 days. ImageKit offers a powerful media API that helps upload and update the details of your media assets. This helps creative teams in bulk operations. Refer to our docs to know more. Go ahead and try ImageKit today.